Hello and welcome to our channel. In this video, I'll show how to set up and run mPower analog EMIR analysis from Synopsys Custom Compiler and do cross-probe highlight EMIR violation back to the layout window. Siemens released the mPower Electro Migration and IR Drop Analysis as a new product in September of 2021. In this initial release, a designer manually creates a tickle file having the EMIR options, with a script that can execute mPower analog from the command line. In the 2023.1 release of Calibre, the mPower flow was enabled in the Calibre Interactive GUI for simplified setup and ease of use. A video on YouTube shows how to set up and run mPower analog dynamic EMIR analysis from Calibre Interactive mPower GUI. Designers can create custom integrations in design tools like Cadence Virtuoso or Synopsys Custom Compiler to launch mPower EMIR analysis from their design environment. In order to set up mPower analog integration to Synopsys Custom Compiler, you first need to set the environment variable mgc_caliber_viewer_menu_cmds to point to a custom Calibre menu file. This will enable users to see and choose the option to launch mPower from the menu in the Custom Compiler design window. Here is an example of the Calibre viewer menu command file. It tells me I will see a run mPower menu item before start RVE menu item. Select run mPower will execute the batch command, calibre-gui-mPower. With this integration setup, you can select Calibre, run mPower to launch Calibre Interactive mPower GUI. The Calibre Interactive mPower GUI allows designers to set up and run mPower EMIR analysis. First, specify Calibre LVS SVDB path and the names of your power and ground rails and voltage value on the design info page. Second, specify how you want to run EMIR analysis on the Analyze EMIR page. You can specify IR drop only, or both EM and IR drop analysis. You may also choose running static, dynamic, or both static and dynamic EMIR analysis. Third, specify the waveform type pre-layout or post-layout, path of waveform result file, and make third to annotate waveform for dynamic EMIR analysis on SDB PSDF info page. Fourth, specify where you want to run mPower, from local host, remote host, or LSF grid, and slots to run mPower. Finally, click the Run mPower button to create the mPower tickle run script and run mPower. When the run is completed, the mPower analog debug GUI opens. You can click any results button to load the result data and see the color map in the GUI. I'll choose the dynamic power EM average results as an example to show how to cross-probe results to Synopsys Custom Compiler. To enable mPower direct cross-probe highlight to custom design tool, select Setup RVE from the mPower Calibre menu and click Connect button to create the connection. To view the worst 10 results, select Report Worst End from the mPower results menu. Click on an item in Worst and Results dialog. It highlights the violation to both the mPower GUI and Custom Compiler layout window. That's all there is to it. If you enjoyed this video, please give us a thumbs up. Or if you want to suggest a new video topic, please drop your suggestion in the comment section below.